Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I am your host, Susan Jo Philip, and these are the major news stories of the day. Heavy rain continued to lash in Kerala. IMD issues yellow alert in 5 districts. Amid the political debate over the JDS National Committee's decision to join hands with the BJP-led NDA, leaders of its Kerala unit visited the party patron H.D. Devegowda in Bengaluru and informed him that they would not support NDA. Congress leader Rahul Gandhi has been faced with yet another defamation suit. Lucknow court has issued notice to the Wayanad MP over derogatory remark against Hindutva ideologue Savarkar. Afghan embassy ceases operation in India, citing lack of support from the Indian government. And finally, US Congress avoided a government shutdown in last-minute deal. Let's get into the details. Kerala will continue to witness heavy rain accompanied by lightning and strong winds in the next 5 days under the influence of the depression over the Arabian Sea, alerted India Meteorological Department. A yellow alert has been sounded for 5 districts, Alappuzha, Ernakulam, Thrissur, Kozhikode and Kannur on Sunday. The incessant rains left many places inundated in southern Kerala and houses were also damaged in several places. Thrissur district witnessed an average rainfall of 43.83 mm in the past 24 hours, informed authorities. 4 shutters of Pumala Dam were raised by 2.5 cm on Sunday morning. The water level at Cholaya Dam was 2,661.10 feet and Peringal Kuthu Dam 419.4 meter at 7 a.m. respectively. Amid the political debate over the Janata Dal Secular National Committee's decision to join hands with the BJP-led NDA, leaders of its Kerala unit visited the party patron and former Prime Minister H.D. Devegowda in Bengaluru and informed him that they would not support NDA. JDS State President Matthew T. Thomas said that Devegowda accepted the Kerala unit's decision. "We informed Devegowda that we won't join hands with BJP at any cost. He understood our emotions," he said. The Kerala unit of the party, which is a major ally of LDF, has come under fire after the National Committee of the Karnataka-based party joined the NDA ahead of the general elections. The opposition even demanded the removal of Electricity Minister K. Krishnakutty from the state cabinet and asked him to declare whether he was continuing in the cabinet as a representative of the BJP or not. Congress MP Rahul Gandhi has been faced with yet another defamation suit. This time, a sessions court in Uttar Pradesh's Lucknow district has issued a notice to Gandhi in connection with his derogatory remark made against Vinayak Damodar Savarkar in Maharashtra last year during his Bharat Jodo Yatra. The notice has been issued by Lucknow district and sessions judge Ashwini Kumar Tripathi on a criminal revision plea filed by advocate Nripendra Pandey challenging an order passed by additional chief judicial magistrate Amrish Kumar Srivastava dismissing his complaint against Gandhi, noting that the revision was liable to be admitted as it involved questions of law and fact. The court also transferred the case to the additional sessions judge Lucknow. The next hearing on the matter will take place on November 1, 2023. The Afghanistan embassy in India announced Saturday night that it is ceasing its operations from October 1, citing a lack of support from the Indian government, failure to meet expectations in serving its interest, and reduction in personnel and resources. In a statement, the embassy in New Delhi said it made careful considerations before arriving at the decision. "It is with profound sadness, regret and disappointment that the Embassy of Afghanistan in New Delhi announces this decision to cease its operations," the statement said. The embassy said that this decision was made taking into account the historic ties and long-standing partnership between the two countries. The US Congress passed a stopgap funding bill late with overwhelming Democratic support after Republican House Speaker Kevin McCarthy backed down from an earlier demand by his party's hardliners for a partisan bill. The Democratic majority Senate voted 89-9 to pass the measure to avoid the federal government's fourth partial shutdown in a decade, sending the bill to President Joe Biden, who signed it into law before the 12:01 a.m. ET deadline. McCarthy abandoned party hardliners' insistence that any bill pass the House with only Republican votes, a change that could cause one of his far-right members to try to oust him from his leadership role. The House voted 335-91 to fund the government through November 17, with more Democrats than Republicans supporting it. That move marked a profound shift from earlier in the week, when a shutdown looked all but inevitable. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Susan Jo Philip. Daily News Dose podcast is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical production by Idea Brew Studios. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.